And welcome back to the show, everybody. Earlier, Buddha was talking with NAMI Utah because we've been doing it a lot lately. Mental health is so important, and I think we've all realized that this last year. I want to introduce you to Desi Garcia. She is with Candle in a Dark Room organization. Yes. Hi, Desi.
Hi.
So good to meet you. I know we've been chatting on Instagram. Yes. It's fun to have you in studio, but wow, you've got quite the organization, and you are helping people who have dealt with physical and sexual trauma. So let's talk about your organization and how you came up with the name.
So I'm a survivor myself of child sexual abuse, and I started off as a podcast, and it was just to bring awareness and have an outlet for people to be able to tell their story. And I just kind of, I don't know, the name just kind of came to me one day. Like, you need just a little bit of light to get out of that darkness. And that, for me, that's what I needed. And I found that light within myself to help guide me out of the darkness.
Okay, now I know that on your website you have a little bit about your story. Yes. Do you mind sharing just a little bit with our viewers so they can understand?
Yeah, so like I said, I am a survivor of childhood physical and sexual abuse. I was sexually abused from age 8 to 15 by my stepfather, my old stepfather, excuse me. At 15, I decided to, I finally got brave and decided to ask for help, and I told a teacher at school, and I actually ended up in a residential treatment program for 2 years. I lived there to just heal from my trauma and mental health. I was diagnosed with dissociation identity disorder and many other things, and so I just knew there's more, that we need more outlets out there. There's just not enough. There's not enough resources for survivors. There's AA, there's all of those things for, you know, addicts and other problems that people have, but not for sexual and physical trauma. There's not very many options.
Well, listening to your story, I mean, it's so hard for people to wrap their brain around, how does this happen, you know, within a family a lot of time if they've never experienced it. But it reminds me of Coco Berthman's story, who we had on the show, and I know that she's going to be speaking at your event, and she, same thing, her family was putting her through that sexual abuse, and it is so traumatizing, you know, and it's more common, I'm finding out, than I think a lot of us know.
Right, it's definitely more common that, you know, it happens, your neighbor, your backyard, you never know. You know, my mom did not know, my family didn't know. He was very good at hiding it and manipulating me to hide it as well. So, you know, I had to learn to become a good liar, and that's what I did to survive. And so,
Well, let's talk about your organization and what you're doing.
Okay.
You've got a retreat coming up.
Yes.
You are here to help people, you know, whether it's the physical sexual abuse or any kind of extreme trauma, that's what you're here to help with. So this Still I Rise retreat, tell us about it.
Yeah, so we are going to be in Linden, Utah, and it is from July 22nd through the 25th. Mm-hmm. We are going to be staying at the Marriott. You can choose between a VIP pass where you can stay at the Marriott and then experience everything, or you can have the local pass, which is where you just basically go home at night and sleep at home, but you can still experience everything. So those are the two options. And then that Friday night, which is the 23rd, we are going to be having it's called Light Up the Night Banquet. Okay. And that's where we will have Coco Berthman, Elizabeth Smart, myself, Candace Rivera from Exodus, they fight human trafficking. And then we will also have some other survivors there as well. So we are going to just be speaking and raising awareness, and we have a raffle, you know, lots of good things coming. It's just going to be a night to bring awareness to this issue. It's for male and female. The retreat is just for women, but the banquet itself is for either.
Okay. So. And so if they want to go, they can get tickets. I imagine there might be somebody that out there is listening and thinking, I can't afford to do this. If they're in a situation like you might have grown up in, so can somebody sponsor them? Or
we actually have a handful of women right now that really, really want and need to come, but unfortunately, you know, it costs, you know, it does have a cost, and so if you are willing to sponsor, that would be amazing. We do have a couple people that have stepped in to sponsor some women, and I just think it's an awesome gift to be able to give to a survivor, for them to be able to go through this and give them a weekend of just healing and peace and to rejuvenate. You know, 2020 was hard for everybody, so I think we all need something like this, and this is the perfect time to get together and do this. So,
and check out their website, even if you can't make it to the retreat and it's something you want to get into their support group. Their monthly things they do. Desi is here for you along with others, and it will be so impactful. So, Desi,
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you.
Buddha, what's coming up?